هيا على الفلاح.
So the hadith says, I heard Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, أيها الناس أفشوا السلام وأطعموا الطعام وصلوا الأرحام وصلوا بالليل والناس نيام تدخلوا جنة ربكم بسلام. O people, spread the salam. First word. Look, it rhymes, isn't it? The words are rhyming. This was the first words that Abdullah ibn Salam heard. O people, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, O people, spread the salam. Salam means peace. So spread peace. But primarily it is the greeting. Assalamu alaikum. What is the meaning of assalamu alaikum? We say peace be upon you. If you look at what it actually means, it means I promise you I will not harm you. That's what it means. Because if I say peace be on you, that means may there be no war on you, right? May there be nothing harmful on you, right? Who is talking? I am talking. So I am the one who is telling you that I won't harm you. The problem with us, we say salamu alaikum and we are beating them. Salamu alaikum, we are cheating. Salamu alaikum, we are deceiving. Salamu alaikum, as soon as we go back, we're backbiting about them. That is where the problem lies. I promise you, if you want to better the condition of your family, your broader family and your community and the ummah, learn to say only good things about people behind their backs. And I promise you, life will change. Life will change. If you guarantee that you will only say good things about others behind their backs, everything will change. Community will become a better place. Because it will work. The problem with us, behind the backs, we say bad. In front, we have such a smile, subhanallah, that hypocrisy will destroy us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and may He make us from those who realize. So the first one, spread the salam. The second one, at'imu at'ama, which means feed the food. Feed the food here. To whom? Two types of people. Those who may be wealthy and those who are poor as well. Your relatives and those who are not related. So sometimes you get your friends and you are gathering, mashallah, you have food, alhamdulillah, and inshallah, if you have cooked and prepared more, you may later on want to pack what is remaining and give it to the poor. That is an act of worship. And I'm so happy to see in so many countries, including in this country, where there are people now who are taking a keen interest in packing and distributing the good leftover food to give those who are less privileged. Wallahi, it is an act of worship. If you eat one morsel and there is another morsel remaining that you did not eat, do not throw it away. If it is good enough to eat, please pack it and look for someone who needs it. Search for him, because that search will make your door to Jannah very simple. But if you are just to throw it in the bin, my brothers and sisters, you'd rather cook less. You'd rather cook less or order less. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who don't waste. So to feed the food, learn to feed the poor as well. Learn to reach out to them. Learn to donate. Learn to give. That's what it is. When you give, Allah will give you. Anfiq, yabna Adam, yunfaq alayk. Spend, O son of Adam, and it shall be spent upon you. Allah will grant you sustenance. One of the ways of earning more money is to put money. When you have a business, what do you need to do? You need to put capital, then you will get profit, right? If you don't have the capital, how are you going to start your business? So you need to put in something, then you will get out something. The same applies to the deeds. You need to do something, then you will get the result of it. So if you spend, it will be spent on you. Subhanallah. The same applies in the farm. You cannot just sit because you have a large tract of land and wait for the dates to grow. You didn't plant anything. How can you do that? You're foolish. Oh, I bought a dates farm. If you bought a dates farm, you are going to be working very, very hard to ensure that everything is in order. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. Then, silul arhama actually means to maintain your family ties. Every extended family has to have some form of politics. Remember that. It is impossible to have a big extended family without some misunderstanding. Why? Because that is part of your test from Allah. Allah made you related in order to test you. Will you actually go out and resolve the matters, or you don't want to solve the problem? If you have a family problem, you have not spoken to your brother or your sister for 5 years, tonight is the night. Pick up the phone, forgive each other, and continue. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us وصلوا الأرحام from the mouth of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Your family members, that's your brother, that's your wife, your in-laws, your family members, your children. Some parents don't talk to their own children and they have a bad relationship. Some siblings, they are fighting. Why? We are Muslimin. If you want your path to Jannah to be made easy, solve your problem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to resolve our matters. And then the last part of that hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Sallu bil layli wan nasu niyam." Pray at night when the people are sleeping. Call out to Allah. With us, you know when we do that? When we have a problem. This is why the hadith says, "Inna Allah idha ahabba 'abdan ibtalah." When Allah loves you, He tests you. Because when He puts a calamity and a problem in your life, suddenly you become pious because now you quit your sin because you know you have a disease that you need cure for. And you suddenly go to the masjid for salah. And you are there for tahajjud. And you get up very late at night and you are crying to Allah. Because why? The doctor told you have 4 months to live. Subhanallah. Imagine. So wasn't that a gift for you? Wasn't that a very big gift that you had a big problem, financial problem, this problem? That was a gift. Allah blessed you with a problem so that you come closer to Allah. That was the gift of Allah. But you did not realize that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy. So if we are to pray at night while everyone is sleeping, then the hadith says, what my right hand has spent. Subhanallah. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my beloved brothers and sisters, that is also a beautiful way of entering Jannatul Firdaus. Another way of entering Jannah, visiting the sick and the ill. Iyadatul Marid. Imagine how many different ways there are to enter Jannah. Do we have even one of them? Few of them? If there was only one way, then I think we would have been at a loss. But there are thousands of ways so that, you know, it reminds me of a huge highway with so many lanes and all of them are going to Jannah. Find yourself at least in one of those lanes. So what do you do? There is a beautiful hadith, subhanallah, hadith of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked a question to the Sahaba. He said, who is fasting today? So the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu said, Ana, I. Then he says, who has followed the janazah today? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu said, Ana, I. Subhanallah. The Sahaba were just looking. Then he says, who has fed a poor person today? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu said, Ana, I. Subhanallah. Then he asked, who has visited a sick person today? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu says, Ana. Says, I. All of these things. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, and this is the hadith of Abu Hurairah in Sahih Muslim. He says, whoever has done all of these will get Jannah. Subhanallah. Imagine visiting the sick. Why? The sick, they need a boost. They need a moral boost. Subhanallah. They need someone to at least say, inshallah, you'll be okay. Don't worry. Mashallah, we are with you. Thank you so much for listening to this short message. I pray that it has increased you in a little bit of motivation and hope. And the same applies to all of us. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.